Everybody hear me? Vote. Please be seated. My grandfather, on my mother's side, was an interesting man. At the age of 20, he left Minneapolis, Minnesota, where he grew up, city kid. Went to southern Idaho and decided to become a rancher. Established his claim on property that was still then available for homesteading, and started to raise cattle. Some years later, he met my grandmother, who was a Scottish immigrant. And she pointed out, you know, we're really not doing very well raising cattle. They were in a part of the country that didn't have a lot of good grazing land. So she convinced him, being a good Scottish she is, that he needed to raise sheep. So he started raising sheep, and that worked out well for him. He did that for probably 40 years. When I was a child, when I was in junior high and late grade school, I used to go down in the summertime and spend a week or two on the ranch with my grandparents, a time which I always enjoyed thoroughly. And during that time, I got to know a little bit about sheep. I'm certainly no expert, but one thing I did learn about is that sheep are not very good at taking care of themselves. In fact, they do a very bad job of it. They need someone to take care of them, but simply don't, they're not able on their own to feed themselves and take care of themselves and keep themselves safe. For that, they depend on someone else. In this case, it was my grandfather, who was not exactly a shepherd because he owned the land that he raised sheep on, so he didn't take them out as the itinerant sheepherders do, who raise them on public lands. But that's a whole different story. I won't get into sheepherders and how interesting they are. Not to say that they're socially acceptable, but anyway. One thing I do remember is when I would out call my grandfather to deal with sheep in the summertime, he would make this most interesting sound. It was kind of a trilling sound. Now, in every flock, there is a sheep commonly known as the bellwether, although in my grandfather's case, there's usually an old dry ewe, who had a bell around his neck. And the sheep, hearing that bell, would follow the sound of it. That bellwether would respond to my grandfather's voice and come, bringing the flock with him or her. They knew that voice. No matter how hard I tried, I could not emulate that sound. I could not make the sound in my grandfather's voice that would cause the sheep to come to me, because they knew his voice, and they responded to his voice. And Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me." Just as my grandfather's sheep would follow him when they heard his voice, Jesus is saying, "I am your shepherd. When you hear my voice, follow me." Now, this went over really well with the great unwashed masses in Galilee. Didn't go over so well with the authorities in Jerusalem. Jesus was a most interesting character, of course. And he was, among other things, a radical preacher who challenged everything that the religious authorities in Jerusalem stood for. They viewed him as dangerous, someone who challenged their authority, as someone who would draw the people from them to himself. They couldn't tolerate. He was an outsider, not part of their inner circle. And yet here he was in the temple itself, challenging. They did not take well to that. Because they were very busy doing God's work. So busy, in fact, that they forgot about God. I read a quote this week from one of my favorite lay theologians, C.S. Lewis, in which he said, he was speaking of the European missionaries of the 19th and 20th centuries, some people spend so much time spreading the word of Jesus, or spend so much time preaching Christianity that they forget about Christ. In other words, they're telling people, okay, this is what you got to do, and that's what they concentrate on. Trying to turn people into their concept of a good Christian. Instead of listening to the voice of Christ, they're looking to their own traditions. Just as the authorities, the temple authorities in Jesus' time in Jerusalem did. They were so busy, this religious elite, wielding their authority and making people behave the way they thought they should behave and doing what they considered to be God's will. Because they were, after all, encouraging people, actually demanding that people follow God's law. Which was fine, except that they were so interested in God's law, they forgot about God. They forgot to listen to the voice. Jesus said to them, you don't believe because you don't belong to my sheep. And why is that? Because you don't listen to my voice. In other words, he's still telling them, I'm not the outsider, you are. You first refuse to hear my voice. You refuse to humble yourselves and acknowledge that you're no better than any other of God's children. Oh, they love their positions of authority, just as religious leaders all over the world do today. They love their authority, they love the power they have over people. But one question is how much they actually love the God that they were supposedly serving. And Jesus said to the sheep, his followers, I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What the Father has given me will not be taken from me. Now, we all know that in reality, some of the sheep are going to be lost. Some of them will wander away. Some of them will be attacked by, will be killed by predators. Some of them will simply starve to death because they don't know where to go for food. But it's because they stop listening to the shepherd's voice. They're leaving the flock as their own choice. They're not taken from the flock. They choose to leave on their own. They are on their own, not because the shepherd abandoned them, but because they stopped listening to his voice. They stopped even trying to hear his voice and wandered off to do their own thing. Now the good news of all this is that they were always welcome back if they made it back in time. Everyone is invited to be a part of this flock. No matter how many times you wander off and come back, you're always welcome. Everyone, no one is excluded from this great flock. No one. It doesn't matter what color you are, what you believe, it doesn't matter what your sexual orientation, nothing, none thing that matters is that you are one of God's sheep, one of God's children. And so when you listen to that voice, the voice of God calling you, telling you, no, I don't think you probably ought to be doing this. You probably ought to kind of turn this way a little bit. When we listen to that voice, we will be safe. We will be a part of this great flock of people that's being cared for by a loving God, a loving shepherd. He will never abandon us. And no matter how many times we abandon him, he always welcomes us back. And it's when we recognize that, that we will truly be able to say, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not.